my soul so weary. When troubles come and my heart burdened be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be.
But we've been fortunate to have a small handful of people who are committed and farsighted. Pat Crow is one of those people. I will confine my comments to meeting Pat at the beginning of the Woodward Project in 1995, when KPAC was being formed, the Knox Performing Arts Coalition, to take on the project of restoring the Woodward. Shortly after that formation, it became clear before too long that this was a much bigger project than we originally envisaged, and the personnel in the KPAC were really not up to such a big project. So Pat took it upon himself to begin to cultivate a relationship with a number of business and civic leaders that resulted in the formation of the Woodward Development Corporation in 1998. Since then, since the formation of the Woodward Development Corporation, Pat has demonstrated leadership, vision, and competence, but most importantly to me is his character trait of indefatigable abilities. Pat is simply incapable of being fatigued or worn down by events that are standing in obstacles that are standing in the way of his achieving some goal. Again and again, he has demonstrated to members of the board and myself at the Woodward this trait, and it's very, very important, because from the beginning, when people thought the Woodward was a project that just, why don't we just tear the building down, to now, why isn't it complete? Pat has persisted and overcome so many obstacles to the point where I feel very confident that the Woodward will be a completed project.
Well, the two things that come to my mind when I think of Pat Crow are his dedication and also his perseverance relative to the Woodward Opera House and the Danamit Music and Arts Festival. I don't know how many years he's been involved, but I know it's been for a long time with both projects. And the Woodward Opera House, although not completed, looks so much better on the exterior, and I know they're making progress on the interior. And I don't know how the Music and Arts Festival would have been done without Pat's continual input, hard work, and perseverance over so many years. Well, my understanding of the Walward Rudin Award is somebody that has done a lot for downtown Mount Vernon. And in terms of both what I mentioned previously about the Music and Arts Festival and also the Woodward Opera House, those mean so much to downtown Mount Vernon in different ways, but still they both mean a lot to what's going on downtown Mount Vernon. The Woodward, when it's done, is going to be a real jewel in downtown.
Pat's influence and impact on downtown Mount Vernon will be felt for generations to come. What he and Sandy and the Woodward Development Corporation have done in moving the Woodward Opera House forward, as well as their growth of the Danamit Music and Arts Festival, their tireless promotion of Knox County, and their creation of the National Historic District has really put Mount Vernon on the map as a premier destination in Ohio. As a new downtown manager, I have really appreciated Pat's participation in our board of directors, as well as his insights and advice on how to work with people downtown and how to really get things done in our community. I've always appreciated his candor, his encouragement, and his great sense of humor as well.
You know, going back probably 18 years to when I first became mayor and Pat became kind of a driving force for the rehab of the Woodward Opera House, but doing all of that, raising money, hiring architects, being a driving force, he also found time to energize the downtown Central Business District. He was active in the Heritage Association, the parking company, and about everything else that people count on to keep the downtown business district viable. Well, I'm old enough to remember Walter Rudin, and I remember when he had his department store. I remember talking to him on his sidewalks. Walter Rudin was a wonderful person, but also dedicated to downtown. And Pat Crow is dedicated to downtown, making it a better place. And I think that's why I think he's deserving of this special award.
Oh, I wish I was in the land of cotton, cinnamon seed and sandy bottom. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland, in Dixie's land, where I was born in early on a frosty morning. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland. Then I wish I was in Dixie. Hooray, hooray, in Dixie's land we'll take our stand to live and die. Drive away sorrow, come and hear this song tomorrow. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland. Then hoe it down and scratch your gravel. To Dixie's land I'm bound to travel. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland. Then I wish I was in Dixie. Hooray, hooray, in Dixie's land we'll take our stand to live and die. Dixie.
The thing that makes Pat stand out is that he's pretty steadfast. He doesn't get discouraged, he just bounces back. I suppose like the little bunny that keeps on going, Pat does. And we've hit, over the years, we've hit some pretty big obstacles in this renovation and even in the downtown area. But Pat is deserving because he keeps on going. You know, Pat and I have something in common. We're both Danville boys. Now, I'm a little older than he is. But ever since I became mayor and he came in the Visitors Bureau, we've had a close working relationship. I've been pleased with that because he's a guy that can make things happen, and that's what mayors appreciate.
Well, over the past 20 years, Pat has written and administered three downtown revitalization grants for downtown Mount Vernon, two Tier 3 grants on the Woodward. He's just done a lot of different things. We have quite a love for downtown Mount Vernon. At one time, we were merchants in downtown Mount Vernon. I know that to him, downtown Mount Vernon and Knox County is very special. We've lived all over the United States, and we chose to come back here. And This has been a great community to raise our children and our grandchildren in. So we're very partial to the area.